This is the oldest Jain temple in Delhi. And high up on the temple, first of all, you've got the triptych there. You've also got the wheel right there, the wheel of Dharma, if you will. There's further temple complexes around here. But notably right now, there's this big facade up here. But this is the Red Fort from the 17th century. And among other things here on this fort, well, first up, you have the Indian flag up there. Again, it has that wheel on it, the chakra wheel, but the wheel would have a lot of symbology as per the zodiac and further aspects. Notably here, the seven in between the pillars of Jachin and Boaz there. Another many aspects, but one of the aspects is that you will notice the doorways to nowhere, and in this case, significantly, they're within the etheric archways right there. We'll have a further look. Now, on the subject of doorways to nowhere, so to speak, you have the famous one in Peru. You also have them in Egypt also. Now, in this one in Egypt, you have the woman there, and this has been explained away as some sort of way of giving birth. But I would suggest there's more to it. It's alchemy being portrayed here in a cryptic kind of a way. You have obviously the shape-shifted sort of entities there to the side, the astral entities to the sides. This is some sort of ritual scenario, I would certainly suggest. And then with the vagina and all the rest of it, as a kind of portal from the body, if you will. Now, if you go to India, you have another kind of similar configuration there. And in this case, you have the flower. We keep seeing the flower at the head there also. So explaining this away as a birthing thing is right up there with the light bulb scenario and stuff from Dendera, Egypt.
Again, here you have the doorways to nowhere inlaid into the side of the building. Now, this building is massive. It's absolutely massive. This massive fort, it was a residence for 200 years. Just looking up here, right up, another look at those doorways. So in this case, we can actually go through what is the Lahore Gate, and you can see the flowers up here around the gate. So the people walk through. So you have the archways around the people walking through as part of the architecture.
So yes, you have the people walking through, but you have to get rid of the physical bodies, get rid of them. You have to think about the sort of astral entities being in those spaces of etheric matter around them. Now, you have the flowers up. Now, there could be one figure there, or there could be multiple figures within that kind of doorway configuration. Now, you have the flowers up there also. If you look at the flower, it kind of like looks a little bit portal-like in a way too. With this depiction, you have the entities at the flowers. And of course, if you've looked at my work, you will know about the flowers and portals and this aspect. But further from this, if we look at further depictions from India, you can see those two flowers up there, and also what is perhaps, whether portals or not, is an astral configuration, I would certainly suggest. This is why billions of dollars have been put into, you know, depicting this stuff around the world.
More of those doorways. I'm actually right under the main entrance right now, with the seven represented there between the pillars, pillar-like of Jachin and Boaz. And indeed, you have the same kind of configuration here also. We have the doorways once again. Now, interestingly enough here, you have the newer wall with the smaller stones, and then you have the larger masonry pieces, larger blocks, not exactly megalithic, but the larger blocks on the older construction. Just noticing the further sort of foliage going up there at this gate, and also the kind of perch there for a risen character, light body perhaps. Here we have a plan. Now it's extensive, so this is an extensive building, a residence and also a fortress. The juxtaposition here of the doorways to nowhere and the doorway to somewhere through. So through rock and then through the stone as well. Stone into light in a kind of our three-dimensional physical reality. So within the fort, within here, you have the geometric kind of auric lattice work within the dome here, which is similar to what you get, of course, around the world. Some of the depictions in here, you have the grail, they've protected them here, and a further grail also. Kind of tree of life configurations in here, along with these ones up here, and then the classic depictions of the flowers and the garland configurations with the spiral within the auric edifice of this doorway to nowhere right there. A further shot of the complex right here. It's massive. Interesting up here, the kind of diamond configurations, light configurations, and the detail. The tree of life kind of configurations in there, and then on the outside of this building also you have that same configuration. Of course you would have the participants standing in the center also, and you'll see the same configuration of the flowers here also that we saw just before. This is a shot of the central kind of pathway coming through the Red Fort. Lull is red. Lull. So within the Red Fort here, going directly up the main aisleway, we come into this rather elaborate building, and you have the centerpiece right here. Now you would have the same kind of centerpiece in the Vatican, and one of the main similarities is that it's covered in the foliage as well, which is this flow through, I would certainly suggest, an etheric flow through from the great architect of the universe. So we basically have the same sort of pergola type configuration with the pillars of foliage, and it's symbolism that many will fail to see, I guess, but we also have the doorways there, curiously, coming through from the back. And within here, we have the some birds within there also. Although they are not the more sort of like the astral looking fish and the astral looking foliage. But nonetheless, they are there with the sunflowers also. So another thing to point out up here is that you have the doorway, but this time with the configuration of the flowers and the tree of life within it. Just a bit of another view here as the camera adjusts, with the archways running through, archways and pillars. Within this shot, you have the juxtaposition of the, in a way, the archway right here, the cupola, the dome right there, and then you have it in the negative, this configuration right here, all a configuration of light, as per the likes of Furze Maurice, author Furze Maurice. We'll quickly have a look. yet another temple within here, and you can see the triptych up there. Also on the walls you have the kind of doorway to nowhere configuration, as I put it. Now within here the best detail is actually within, but it's guarded through here. But I'll just try and get some of the ceiling through here. And you can see that once again the foliage inlaid everywhere around here. You can see up here the detail of the ring, and you see this on Western, Western church as well, that carry-on configuration. And we'll now just have a look around here, and I often make comparisons between what's going on in Egypt and what's going on here. And then right here we have a very interesting one where you have the what is moon and stars with the scales also. There's another shot of the scales amidst the stars and what appears to be the arch of the moon there. This octagonal structure, which no doubt was part of something bigger at some stage, has the steps upon it, which are a reminder of some of the steps in South America, Peru I think it is. The temples within this Red Fort complex are, there's just so many of them, but here we have these little pedestals. That's one of four of them within this complex here. It would have had water in it at some stage in its day, and you have the kind of lotus configuration around the outside here of what is, I would certainly suggest, again, is a configuration. These are configurations of astral type etheric edifices. And so you have the formation in the center of the ritual space right here. And within, of course, within Freemasonry you have those pedestals around, and you see it. Once you know how to look for it, you'll see it over and over and over again. Within here you have, you can see the little flowers in their center shot also. So interesting configuration within the grounds of the Red Fort here. Around this edifice, again, what I would suggest, if you kind of look at the detail, you can see that kind of gushing out, if you will, the etheric kind of foliage gushing out from the center of this edifice right here. So in its heyday, there would have been water throughout these edifices. Now, one thing we have here of interest before this temple here is the layers right there. And so kind of 1, 2, 3. And you can see that it's the kind of auric shape also. So there's another one up here. And you can see this configuration of levels around various individuals within the aura, the kind of levels, if you will. Very interesting, where this brings scale into it. And I certainly wonder if this comes into play in Egypt also. Just having a further look in here. Here you can see the dropping down of pillars in a way, also as part of the configuration here. So in a way they're kind of coming down in this case. So this is the Sawan Pavilion. So this is a pretty awesome place. The Red Fort, showing the, I don't know why, just out of curiosity, they've got the rings up along the sides of this building as if they put something up against there at times. Within here though, again, this is where you have this piece in here, which you see at the Vatican also, this configuration, this light configuration, I would suggest, astral light. So again, this doorway and the diamond-like quality to to the portrayal of light up here. On the side of this building, this is the building with the diamond configurations on it, diamond-like, you have these doorways as we go up to a museum up here. The doorway, and you can see just the fittings on the doorway, very flower-like in a way. Military aspect to India with various grenades up here, along here. Arrows, bow and arrow with the queef, I think it is. Decorated queer. So a real history of, basic history of some weaponry through here.